Assalamu alaikum students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here. So today we are going to solve the adjustments of sole trader accounting question of recent paper 2020, paper 2, variant 2. So let's get started. In order to tell you, we have to make the income statement for the year for 15 marks. And let's start. First, I'll be explaining you all the adjustments 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it says that Gok is a wholesaler and he prepares his financial statements to the end of February each year. This leads us to very important thing. If he is preparing the statements to end of February, which means the year starts on 1st March and ends on the last date of February. Okay, so this is the 12 months are very important, from March to February. That is our basically financial year. Make sure you have a notebook to copy down the important things, formulas and the adjustments how we are solving. And if you have any questions, you can ask in the comments section. So it basically says that we have been given the ledger account balances at 29th February 2020 and revenue, purchases, sales return, the goods that have been returned by our customers to us, discount allowed for the early payment that customers have done. So we have given them some discount allowed. It's an expense. So a lot of more expenses, rent and rates, general expenses, irrecoverable debts, those who cannot pay their owed amount. Then we have insurance, telephone expenses, and inventory, drawings and depreciation as well, that we are going to work it out. So the first adjustment is always related to the closing inventory, and it says that Gok did not have time to count the inventory at the closing date 29th February, but they have given the margin is 25%. So we have been given the margin. Usually it's very easy thing that the first adjustment, they already mention the closing inventory is this amount particular in dollars, and just have to do the required adjustment. But let's try to work it out here how we are going to use the margin. So how they have given the margin, that is 25%, which means of the revenue 25% is the gross profit and 75% will be the cost of sales. Okay, so let's try to work it out. The first thing will be you find out the net revenue, because that is what we need in order to remove the sales return, because some sales have been returned back by our customers. So 420 minus 12,000 will be simply 408,000. So 408,000 dollars is the net revenue, and then out of that basically you find the gross profit, that will be 408 into 25%, that will give us 102,000 as the gross profit. And in order to find the cost of sales, it will be revenue minus the gross profit. So basically I'll just highlight that fact, the revenue minus the gross profit will give us the cost of sales. Okay, so hope everyone follows this. We already have got the cost of sales, which means we can fill out the trading section of that. So let's quickly try to fill out the trading section first. So we have the revenue as 420,000 minus the sales return students, that is basically 12,000. So we got the net revenue students, 420 minus 12 gives us 408,000. And then the cost of sales, the opening inventory is already given to us, that is 26,700. Okay, and then the purchases are there as well, that is 311,400. So we'll write down the purchases as well, and the closing inventory is basically, we'll find out by plugging in that the cost of sales is going to come 306,000. So you'll backtrack that, and the gross profit is basically coming 102,000. Okay, so if we talk about the closing inventory, the closing inventory is going to come 32,100, and I'll explain you through the formula, that is 32,100. So you can just simply apply that formula, that is opening inventory plus purchases minus the closing inventory, and you got the cost of sales. So just solving it as a basically a mathematical equation, you already have opening inventory plus purchases and cost of sales. So you can easily find out the closing inventory using that formula. So it will be 306,000 plus, minus the purchases and minus the opening inventory, and you got the closing inventory at 29th February as 32,100. So this is basically our closing inventory. Next, we'll be talking about the expenses, and let's try to understand that the expenses as well. But before that, let's solve the adjustments. Okay, so adjustment number two says that a loan of $60,000 was obtained from the bank on 1st July 2019, so date is very important, and interest is charged at 7% per annum. Okay, so if we have the date starting from 1st July, which means we'll have to count on the number of months, so it will be July, August, September, October, November, December, January, and February. I hope everyone gets it, because our year ends on 29th February 2020 and we are taking the loan on 1st July. So it's around basically 8 months for which we are using this loan. So we'll have to calculate the interest on that, and that will be $60,000 into 7% into 8 divided by 12. And that will be the loan interest amount that we'll have to pay, and that will be accrued as well, that it will be written as current liability as well later on in the balance sheet, but that's not the target here. So 2800 is basically the loan amount as well. So let's quickly write it down. The loan amount is 2800, loan interest amount. Okay, so this adjustment is done, and the other adjustment will be, let's talk about adjustment number three, that says that the fixtures and fittings are being depreciated at 20% per annum using the reducing balance method. So we'll have to apply the diminishing returns method, the reducing balance method. So let's work on it, and this will be simple, that fixtures and fittings are reducing balance method means that cost minus the accumulated depreciation, that gives you the net book value, and you put the percentage on the net book value. Make sure if anyone have questions, they're asking me. Okay, so it will be simply 120,000 minus 43,200, whatever it gives the answer, you apply the percentage on that. So 76,800 into 20%, that gives me 15,360. Okay, hope everyone is following. So this is the depreciation for there. Let's write the value. Depreciation on fixtures and fittings are 15,360. So we are getting the values one by one for each of the expenses. Hope everyone is clear on adjustment number 1, 2, and 3, how we are finding out those adjustments. Let's talk about the other adjustments as well. So adjustment number 4 says that insurance includes 1500, which covers from the period from 1st March to 30th September, and we'll continue this part in the next video, the second part of this video. Okay, thank you. Hello students, your instructor Abdul Rafi here. So this is the continuation video of the previous adjustments to sole trader question. So let's continue from where we left off on the adjustment number 4. So it says that the insurance includes $1,500, which covers the period from 1st March to 30th September 2020. So the dates will play a very important role here. So let's try to understand that our year starts on 1st March 2019 and it ends on 29th February 2020, okay? And the insurance, it says that the amount for insurance is 4,500, and basically it says that 1,500 is being paid for the period of 1st March to 30th September, which is the next financial year. So this payment is basically a prepaid payment. We have paid for the expenses already. We have paid in advance for this expense. So according to the accruals and matching concept, we will have to remove this amount from this 4,500, and therefore we will get basically 3,000 as our expense for the year that we will transfer in the income statement for the insurance amount. So let's write 3000 there in the insurance value. And for this purpose, let's write adjustment number 3 working as well here. This is number 4. And similarly for the depreciation as well. And you already have the value. So make sure you show the workings to the examiner so he gets satisfied with your answers. Okay. So working number 5, the adjustment number 5 will be students that drawings include a payment of 1660. That is for personal telephone expense. So here we are going to apply the concept of business entity. That is the capital and the drawings should be charged separately. They should be shown separately. The owner cannot withdraw the amount and they have to maintain separately. So that is basically the business entity concept that we are applying here. And this 1660 is the payment for personal telephone expenses, and the 1/4 of this amount was for business use. So 1/4 of this amount is being used for the business use, which means that we will have to charge 1/4 of the amount of 1660 to our income statement. Why? Because this is being used for the business expenses. So for this reason, students will have to allocate this amount into that. So which means the telephone expenses will be adding up the amount in that. So telephone expenses are 4565. The telephone expenses are 4565, and you will add in that $415 to make sure that the adjustment is completed in for the income statement perspective. And when you will make the balance sheet, the statement of financial position, you will have to remove the drawings of 1660 because that is for personal telephone expenses. You will have to remove from drawings of 9500 the amount of 415, so that because one of them was for 1/4 of them was for business use, and the remainings are basically the remaining amount that is from the 1660. That is basically for 1245. That is basically part of the drawings that he has done for personal telephone expenses for his own use. So eventually this is basically for the balance sheet point of view. So in at the moment, because we are only making income statement as the examiner has said, so 4980 will be a part of telephone expenses. We'll complete the remaining expenses as well, students. So we have discount allowed as 9000, wages as 12360. So discount allowed is 9000, wages is 12360. Rent and rates are basically 11750. General expenses, so just we have to complete these amount. General expenses are 4220. Irrecoverable bad debts are 8600. And general rent and rates are 4220. Okay, so when we just do all of them and add all the expenses and get the total expenses for the year, so that eventually the answer will come as the profit for the year, the final profit for the year, and that will result in getting us all 15 marks. Okay, so when I add all these expenses, we should be getting it as 69,200. Let's use a calculator here, and we should be getting 72,070. And when you subtract that from the gross profit, you eventually end up getting 29,930 as the final profit amount. Okay, so this was basically the 15 marks question that we have solved it, and the numerics part. Make sure if anyone have questions, they can ask in the comments section. And everyone is good to go. Thank you for understanding, and stay tuned to the channel for more videos. Thank you, students.